gray.
He goes, do you like your sneaker on the door? I go, why did you do that? He goes, you have a lot of stuff. I thought it looked cute. Thank you. I like my sneaker on the door. I like that you thought my sneaker looked good on the door. Yes, it's a little bag. You didn't know it was a bag? You just thought to hang a shoe on a door?
Stop it! I'm not allowing you on the internet.
Aw, go into the light.
Please.
Come on, little boy. Go into the light. Experience here. He got on a new leather coat. Look at him. He's cute. Yeah. Hello. How are you doing? Are you doing good? Well, shall we check on the plant? Well, it appears that he is growing quite lush by the raccoon, but it is a bit sunburnt over here. The sun has charred these pieces, so I brought it inside. But, wow, we've got quite a bloom over here. Little shorts on today. It's a little bit scandalously short. Okay. Are you going to go get buffalo wings?
Today is the 28th? See what it says today.
Please don't read anything to me. Don't say anything to me. Just give my brain some time to think what I gotta do. Please.
Well, that was weird, don't you think? So how do we move on from that?
Look at these nice pictures of you.
They're not nice, but they're probably not nice.
They're very sweet.
Junk, fucking junk.
You look like a giant here.
Yeah, a milk jug.
You look like a handsome giant. But it's cute. You look handsome. You're cute.
This didn't work. Come out of cutie very good. Oh, she's over. She's over. She's over.
Drop some. Don't pick it up. Just stays there. I need help.
You need help putting on your boot?
No, I'm a wreck. Tired.
Well, I need a different opening now, since you said you will not...
I'm not involved in your video.
Stylish fellows. Oh, you see stylish folks around here.
Gay kid.
They're just cute. I like them. They look cute. I like his little hair and all pump. Look at him. Like a man in a top hat. What is happening here? Let's go. Oh, it's a good place. It's a good place, everybody. Oh, God bless. Oh.
Is it closed? It's closed.
What? No, it's not. It's not open. There's a TV down in there.
Oh,
I'm excited.
It's a good parking, too.
That would help. Look at what we got here. We've been here before and it was delicious. Okay, we got it's getting one of these. Well, you get one and you get another for $2. So each got one of these. Oh, and got mozzarella sticks and the super one with lemon pepper, teriyaki, and garlic wings. That sounds delicious. What's this? That's my house. We played pool last time. It's taken this time. How dare they? How dare they? How dare you? How dare you? I've been a very goofy mood last time. How could you do that? Oh, thank you. He's like, is this the drink? It looks like a water.
Oh my god.
And she just let him think that. She just walked away. Oh! I'm holding stuff.
It's $13.
No, mine was $2. It was one for 13 and another one for 2.
So good.
Oh, I like things that look toxic. Like things that are blue and green.
Still on camera?
Yeah. That's good. You like that?
I am not a cocktail drinker, but I love it.
I'm going right in front of your face.
So good. Oh.
Good.
Wow.
Good?
Amazing.
The teriyaki and the lemon pepper are my favorite. You say you like the garlic one? The two hot. This is my favorite wings. If you like wings, I recommend it. You're in LA. Come here. Because they're not... I like wings, but they're usually all slimy. I don't like slimy wings. They're not slimy here or anything. They're like amazing and perfect. Oh, I love it. Let's try a mozzarella stick. Oh, it's good stuff. I love it. This is good. Did you try a mozzarella stick?
Yeah, really good. They're basic. It's awesome.
Well, every month, you can't go wrong with a mozzarella stick.
So I had a guy come over to me. He delivered some packages to me today. I said, hey, Sonny. Why don't you come on in? Bring those sickles packages on the table. And he said, I'm not supposed to do that. And I said, It's been a while. And you're looking cute with those little brown shorts. And then he's like, well, if you put it that way. And I said, yes. And, well, let's just say it's his, he was tan down below before, within 5 minutes. You get it?
Wow, that worked.
So easy to read. Again, the subject matter in this one is a little bit difficult from time to time, but it's just really, really readable, and because it's written verse, you get through it so fast. And that is none other than The Poet X by Elizabeth Acevedo. I love the writing in here. It is so good. The story itself is so good. It's something that makes you want to keep reading. You don't really want to put this book down. You just want to finish it in one go. It's not very long. It looks so much longer than it actually is. If you even like look at some of the pages, you'll notice like short, you know, like because it's written in verse, it's poetry. It's about 360 pages, but it's actually much shorter than that if you didn't write it down. Just like the lines on them. But it's also just an incredible story with just lavish writing, so well done. Elizabeth Acevedo has a way with words. She's a poet, and it's just a wonderful, wonderful book. It's a book written in verse about a girl who loves spoken word poetry. So I find that really unique as well, and it's just one of my favorite YA contemporaries too, and I highly, highly recommend it if you still haven't picked it up. All right, so my next category is graphic novels, because just like poetry, these are so easy to read, they are so easy to finish.
I'm gonna start talking like this now. Two books came in the mail today. Two of the books I picked out. I hope I will read them. I will. Let's look at them. I guess, you know, there's not a huge rush. No, maybe. We don't have to read them all at once. But I feel like when I'm in the mood, I don't really have much variety, actually. I've had the same books for 10 years, so I grabbed a couple. One of them was I Am Legend. I Am Legend. I really love hearing, I love watching movies with people in isolation. I like reading about people in isolation and the weird little things they do and their rituals. So I'm excited just to hear, like, I'm excited to read about all that. And if it's spooky, that's great. I want to see how he rigs up his apartment, his place. I don't know, I'm excited. Look at books that I am, books like I Am Legend were an inspiration to me. Stephen King. Shall we start reading? Let's read a little bit together. It's part one, January 1976. On those cloudy days, it's a cloudy day. Robert Neville was never sure when sunset came, and sometimes they were in the streets before he could get back. If he had been more analytical, he might have calculated the approximate time of their arrival, but he still used the the lifetime habit of judging nightfall by the sky, and on cloudy days that method didn't work. That was why he chose to stay near the house on those days. He walked around the house in the dull gray of afternoon, a cigarette dangling from the corner of his mouth, trailing thread-like smoke over his shoulder. He checked each window to see if any of the boards had been loosened after violent attacks. The planks were often split or partially pried off, and he had to replace them completely. A job he hated. Today only one plank was loose. Isn't that amazing, he thought.
Should I read it? Like, should we read it together? Could be something interesting. Sounds good.
Have you seen new razor packages here of any kind? Razors?
No. No. I'll look. I also picked up this. This is one of the prettiest covers I've ever seen. This is it. I just thought it was so pretty. So I was kind of judging a book. I don't know. I like that. A magic steeped in a poison. I don't know. It sounds sexy. Then it's the girl said it's tea magic. Red Saint Tail with stunning magic system rooted deep in Chinese mythology. Tea making traditions. Tea magic. Love and magic will flow past the brim of this work of beauty. I don't know, doesn't that sound pretty? I don't know. I'm very particular about if I read anything with fantasy. Like, I don't just like any fantasy. I like spooky and like things with words, a lot of talking about your mental turmoil. Those are my main books. Mental anguish, mental problems, and maybe spooky, and then a lot of Japanese culture books. Those have been my main themes. So don't just go for any old fantasy, but tea magic. That sounds pretty. I like that. We'll see if it's good. It's so pretty. Sometimes you just gotta go for the cover, you know, and hope for the best. Should we start this? Look at, I'm having anxiety. Right at the top. Oh, you are the beginning of everything. Shenong, they say you can spot a true Shenong, she by their hands, palms colored by the stain of the earth, fingertips scarred from the from thorns, a permanent crust of soil and blood darkening the crescents of their nails. I used to look at my hands with pride, and now all I can think is, these are the hands that buried my mother. Oh no. Our house is dim and quiet as I move through the rooms like a thief, rifling through boxes and drawers, fumbling with things my father kept hidden, so as not to be reminded of his grief. I weave between chairs and baskets, drying racks and jars, and my footsteps careful. I can hear Shu coughing softly through the walls, tossing in her bed. She has gotten worse in these past few days. Soon the poison will take her, as it did our mother. Oh no. Which is why I must leave tonight before my father tries to stop me, and I'm bound here by guilt and fear until it is too late. I touch the scroll hidden in the folds of my tunic to reassure myself it is still there, and I find what I'm looking for in the back of the storeroom. My mother's... We gotta learn how to say this. Shenongshi box. Hidden from view in a corner cupboard. Memories slip from beneath the opened lid with a sigh, as if they've been waiting for me there in the tea-scented dark. My fingers over each groove in the wood, touching every compartment, remembering how you repeated the names of the stored items over and over again. This box is a map of her, her teachings, her stories, her magic. But the sight brings back other memories. A broken teacup, a dark stain on the floor. I shut the lid quickly. In the back of the same cupboard, I find other jars labeled in mother's meticulous writing. My hands tremble slightly when I open the jar of last summer's tea leaves, the final harvest I helped her with
helped her with, walking along the garden paths, plucking the leaves from willing branches. As I inhale the scent of roasted leaves, the fragrance turns to bitterness on the back of my tongue, and I'm reminded of how my last attempts at wielding the magic resulted in tears and failure. And I swore I would not touch these tools again, but that was before the scroll appeared on our doorstep. I got a few others. They're going to take a little while. I'll share them as they come. Maybe we'll keep reading together. Would you like to read with me? Look at the view.
Should we pick today? Who feels like the mood today? I don't feel like doing any of this today. Alright, we'll say that she feels like the mood today. Her over here. She feels pretty good. Just neutral. You know, I'm not taking her out, everything will fall. I'm feeling her. It's just like chill. She's chilling out. She's looking cute, chilling out. It's the mood for the day. Maybe a little cosmos. A lot of cosmos. Look at her little glitter ends. I like her a lot. She's cute, isn't she cute? Oh, I wish my hair looked like that. Do you want glittery hair? Me too.
But maybe it's time for a reread. Who knows? That could help you. It could really help you. I just want everyone to read Davy Jones and the Six because I've been screaming about it for years and I'll continue to scream about it because it's so, so good. The next book that I have in this category is, of course, Sadie by Courtney Summers. This is a book that is essentially told in the form of a podcast. And again, listen to the audiobook because it essentially just feels like listening to a true crime podcast because that's pretty much what the book is. Again, it's another book I think you should know pretty much nothing about other than the story is about this girl named Sadie who goes missing, and then we have like this radio show pretty much that's kind of like trying to uncover her story and figure out what happened to this girl. And that's all you should know. Again, please listen to the audiobook. It's such a fun experience. I mean, it's a really sad book, don't get me wrong, but at the same time, it's just such an enjoyable reading experience because it really just feels like a podcast, but it's in novel form, which is so cool and so fun and so unique to anything else I've ever seen. It's another one that is, again, pretty short. It's about 300 pages, maybe just a little bit over that, but not much at all. So you'll fly right through it, and it's a very easy read as well. Again, definitely like darker in terms of the subject matter, but easy to get through because of how compelling and readable it is. So for the next category, I have some poetry books / books that are written in verse. I think poetry is really helpful for helping you get out of a reading slump because they're pretty short for the most part. Sometimes just finishing a book motivates you to keep reading, and I've definitely found that when I'm in a reading slump sometimes. Reading a poetry book, reading something really short, just because I finished it, I feel more motivated to continue to read some more. So that's why I would recommend a couple poetry books. And the first one is one of my favorites, which is No Matter the Wreckage by Sarah Kay. Sarah Kay is one of my favorite poets. If you were online on Tumblr in like 2013, circa 2013-2012-ish, you would know that Sarah Kay had Tumblr and like that whole like,
hey, little bat.
Like by the throat. Her poem, hey, is still bat. One of my favorite poems of all time. If you don't know what I'm talking about, please look it up. It's just a spoken word poem. It's on YouTube. You can watch it. It's so good, and I think about it all the time. But she released a poetry collection a few years ago, and I read it, and I really, really loved this as well. So I'd highly recommend reading this. I think it's wonderful. It's really easy to get through. The poems in here are beautiful, and you'll be able to finish it really quickly, and hopefully that can help you get out of your slump a bit. My other poetry recommendation is actually a novel that is written in verse. I've recommended this several times as well, but it's just because I think it's so good, and it is